Hi class, so today I am going to be talking about a volleyball lesson with people with autism. It's very important for kids with autism and PE to be very patient with them, make sure that they know what's going on. So first off, what we're going to do is we're going to start warming up. So we're going to start right here. But we're just going to do some jog, just get warmed up so we don't pull a muscle. A little warm up to get warm. So after that, we're going to do some stretches. And the first one I want to start off with is, usually, you know, there's a bigger group, there's gonna be a lot of kids, to get in a circle. And I think each week I'm gonna have someone do, or be the leader, you know, in the middle to count. But for the first stretch, we're gonna do our arms and we're gonna count to 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm gonna do the other arm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we're gonna go up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the other arm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. To stretch our legs a little bit, you just bring your leg up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the other leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then we're gonna do some jumping jacks, probably 15 of them. I think this is a great exercise to get them warm, especially with autistic kids. I think it makes them focus on one thing. I think it's just fun for them. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so now after all the students are warmed up, they're going to pick a partner. And this is another little warm-up, but you're going to proceed to the skills that are going to be done. So usually what we like to do is grab the ball with your right arm, and you're just going to step and throw. Just to warm up the arms a little bit. You can do that 5 times on each arm. Have them pass and catch the ball by themselves, just so the balls don't go crazy anywhere and they can be focused on just this specific skill. So what you're going to do is you're going to have your legs wide out and you're going to be down low and you're going to throw the ball to yourself. You're going to do this 10 times just so they can get the rhythm of it and so they can practice control with the ball. Because once it starts getting faster, the balls are going to go everywhere. So you need to spin, catch. Then catch. And you're going to do that, they're going to do that about 10 times. And I'm going to be walking around and making sure they can help. After you practice the motion with passing and catching to yourself, you're going to grab a partner and you're going to do it with each other. So what you're going to do is the same exact thing. Make sure that your legs are low and your platform's out and you're in control with the ball. Make sure you're controlling the ball so it doesn't go everywhere. So what you're going to do is you're going to pass it, catch it, throw it to her, and then pass it, catch it. And you're going to keep doing that over and over. And this is a great way really learn the detail of passing the ball. This is a fun way for them to engage with one another too, and you're just going to do this over and over. And what's fun about this too is that you can tell them, let's see who keeps the ball up the longest and whoever gets the prize. And I think that gets them really excited to learn how to pass. Bump and catch drill with a partner, you're going to move on to setting. And setting is kind of a difficult thing for people, but this is an easy and fun way for, you know, all students, not even autistic kids, to have fun and learn at the same time. So with setting, you're always going to want to keep your hands above your head. And when you're doing that, you have to make sure that your hands are open and it's in a triangle shape, okay? And you want to hit it with your fingertips, not the palm of your hands. So we're gonna do the same thing like the bumping and passing, but setting and passing. So what you're gonna do is setting, you're gonna catch the ball. Setting, catch the ball. And the main important part is to use your legs. You never just wanna use your arms to push it straight up, it's hard. You always wanna get down and stand and push it up. You get more power like that. And you keep going, you're gonna do this about 10 times. Going, make sure you're in control and staying in one spot. Okay, so after you're done individually setting and catching, you're going to grab a partner and you're going to do the same thing, just like the passing and the catching. So what you're going to do, like I stated before, you're just going to make sure your legs are out and make sure to use your legs, not your arms. So you're going to set, catch the ball, and throw it. And she's going to do the same thing. And we're going to do that about 10 times. Something else I wanted to add, just to make this a little bit more fun for the kids. It's fun whenever you get a partner, like the same thing, but instead of catching the ball, you're just going to pass back and forth to each other. I think this is really important because this shows autistic kids that you're trying to get them to learn. Instead of just catching the ball, we're going to go a step up, and I think this is going to get them really excited and fun. So all you're going to do is just how we passed and catched. We're not going to catch the ball. All we're going to do is pass back and forth. And you want to make sure your legs are open, you're in a low stance, and you're just using your body. platform with the straight platform. You're going to do this 10 times. Going to keep going for a little while, and there's going to be more students, obviously, but the fun part is that whenever people are passing like this, I am going to do at the end of practice that there is a prize, whether that is a sticker, a coloring book, whatever it is, and I want them to challenge each other. I want them to keep going and push themselves, so I want students, you know, to get in groups and see how long they can keep the ball up without it falling to the ground. I think this is a really fun activity for students to engage with one another, and I can walk around and see them having fun. I think that's just a great way to play the sport of volleyball with people that are autistic. Thank you. So after the final drill, I think it's very important, just like you warm up at the end, give them time to stretch. I want them to be able to, you know, get loose and come down if they're tired. So just like the warm-up, I'm going to have them get in a big circle, and a different person's going to get in the middle, and they're going to do stretches just like the same ones, with your arms this way and then your arms this way, and even get on the floor. I think this is fun too, so they can do different things and just stretch your legs. You're going to do this for like 15 seconds. And then you're going to do the other leg. And this is whenever I'll be walking around, making sure they're doing everything correct. But yeah, this is a great way for the students to come down for their next, you know, class or anything, so they don't get hurt. But yes, that was it. This was volleyball with autistic students. Thank you.